frost cost the Australian grains industry an estimated $360 million in yield losses annually. Reducing that impact is one of agriculture's highest priorities, and in 2014, the Grains Research and Development Corporation launched a national frost initiative. Grain growers spend an enormous amount of money and months of planning, preparation and nurturing to grow a crop. Yet in one night, a severe frost event can ruin all that work. For more than 40 years, researchers and scientists around the country have been working to minimise that risk. What the National Frost Initiative will do is use that knowledge and steer all current and new frost research down the same track.
The whole point of the initiative is that we can bend it and twist it, shape it to where we go. So we've got a five-year initiative now, and having a steering committee, having a scientific committee around it, we can see what we've achieved and then move forward with the next step. You know, we'll do what we have to do. It's such a big and important stress.
Australian cereals face their greatest risk of frost damage during the reproductive growth stages as heads begin to form and flower. A frost event at that critical growth stage can result in floral sterility, which will lead to reduced crop yields.
Last year was a classic example. If you'd have gone out into the wheat belt in WA in September last year, everybody was on razor blades. Crops were good. They were all just waiting for that bad night, which is exactly what happened in Victoria, New South Wales, South Australia.
Taking a nationally structured approach to frost R&D means there'll be common themes: genetics, management and environment, and a management team to keep the various projects on the same page.
In the genetics program, I think there are about six projects. In the management program, there is about 12 projects. In the environmental program, there are about four projects. Now they have an opportunity through a meeting such as this to come together, to share experiences, but more importantly, to develop common procedures and protocols that would have been impossible prior to this.
It's the coordinated approach that the initiative's management team believes will produce success. Identifying genetic material with improved frost tolerance has to be underpinned by management practices to optimise the potential inherent in that germplasm. Then growers need to adopt those practices into their environment, their farming system. Germplasm is being sourced from around the world.
It'll take 2 or 3 years to import it all, evaluate it all, and see if it has potential in breeding in Australian conditions. And another 5 to 6, maybe even longer years, to actually incorporate that material into genetic material that's useful in Australia.
At the same time imported germplasm is being evaluated, Australian cereal varieties are being ranked for their level of tolerance.
Until recently, it was assumed that there was very little or no genetic variation for frost within Australian varieties, so we assumed everything was equally as susceptible. Since then, we've done some rather extensive testing across Australia as part of a project within the National Frost Initiative to really benchmark current varieties. And within that, we've found a couple of things. So firstly, between different species, so between wheat and barley, there's quite a range of difference in susceptibility to frost. But then also when you look within varieties within wheat and barley, there's also a range of difference within them of a smaller magnitude.
Understanding the genetics makes it simpler and more efficient to develop new varieties. It can also help in the maintenance of yield stability of existing commercial varieties. For example, compensating for damaged flowers on a plant hit by frost by producing larger grains in any surviving seed heads.
Our real strength is that we have probably world-leading genetic resources for getting to naturally occurring genetic variation in traits that matter in a crop. So what we've been doing is setting up a whole series of genetic resources that really let us go from DNA sequence to crop performance in individual traits.
We are interested in what's happening in the chilling period, so in the above zero period, because that's where the plant really gets ready for the more severe frost conditions. So we are interested in finding genetic variability in adapting to cold conditions and hope that that will help the plant to survive frost.
The Frost Initiative's management projects are looking at how farming systems can be manipulated to reduce the susceptibility to frost.
So some of the work which is going on is around looking at crop nutrition, how we can manipulate that. Some of the work's looking at around how we manipulate flowering time and time of sowing and the frost damage we get from that with earlier seeding. And other parts of the work are looking at how we can actually manage the severity and duration of the frost through different management practices which change that. And so we know that we've got some preliminary results and from previous work which has shown that higher stubble loads increase the severity and duration of frost. So we're trying to develop some guidelines around how we manage that within the whole farm business as a frost risk management program.
Many of the initiative's management projects involve GRDC regional cropping solutions networks and grower groups, while the environment program will include climatic research.
Having created this initiative, the opportunity is there to deliver something which would not have been possible 5 to 10 years ago. And certainly the science is getting smarter, the genetic solutions are cleverer, and certainly the climatological developments and forecasting developments are going at quite a pace now with international collaboration. So there's probably never been a better time to couple all this together and produce information. And if that fits the same window as increasing awareness about incidence of frost, then it's a double win, if you like.
To ensure grain growers hear regular and consistent messages about the initiative's outcomes, a knowledge manager will run the dog around the program leaders and management team. And there'll be a one-stop shop growers can use to find management tools and resources. The National Frost Initiative's objective is to provide RD&E solutions to manage the impact of frost and minimise seasonal profit variability. And most growers would share its chairman's objective.
What I would really like to be able to do is that, given that I probably experience 7 times out of 10 the opportunity to sow really early, to be able to capture that. And the thing that stops me now, and stops most farmers now, is the fear of frost at the back end. So early sowing opportunities, varieties that we can capture that with, and to be able to do that with confidence, knowing at the back end I've got some solutions.
GRDC's minimum contribution to the National Frost Initiative will be $23.5 million over 5 years. It's the type of investment that will result in plenty of people with their heads down, getting on with the job. And that has to be encouraging for the grains industry as a whole.